Our next three guests are really remarkable young New Zealanders stamping their mark on Aotearoa and on our future. And it's not just me saying that. They've all just been announced winners of the inaugural PCF, that's Pacific Cooperation Foundation Youth Leadership Awards, for their outstanding services to their communities and therefore to us all. I'm delighted to be joined by award-winning playwright and so much more than that, Leki Jackson-Bourke, winner of the Young Pacifica Male of Influence Award. Look at you, you fine young man. A youth activist and very dear friend of Breakfast. It's so good to have you back. Aigagalefili Fepulea'i-Tapua'i, winner of the Supreme Award for Pacific Youth Advocacy and regular guest on Breakfast this year and a star of the program. And joining us from Wellington, Dr. Brittany Stanley-Wishart, winner of the Pacifica Health Ambassador Award. Dr. Stanley-Wishart, it is so good to have you with us. Thank you so much. All three of you, and congratulations on being winners. Dr. Stanley-Wishart, I'm going to bring you in because you're on your own in Wellington. It's a bit odd sitting there on your own. What was it like to win this award?
It was a real honour and a privilege, to be honest. Just very grateful. Yeah.
Yeah. You're already making a difference, and I'm turning my page because I want to get the name of it right. Pacifica Students in Health New Zealand, Passions, P-A-S-H-N-Z. You formed that. Why?
I guess a lot of the Pacific Health Professional students, when they graduate into the workforce, they're immediately part of the Pacific Health workforce and expected to be competent, expected to be have a good knowledge base, etc., and be connected. But that's not often the case. We come from very different backgrounds. So it's really just an opportunity to create a more competent, cohesive, connected Pacific Health workforce for the future, starting with the students. So, yeah.
And the buy-in's been wonderful, hasn't it? I mean, people have just been delighted by it, haven't they?
Yeah, there's been a lot of good support from NGOs and other organisations and Pacific leaders around the country, so that's been amazing.
Yeah, well, congratulations, and congratulations on all you've achieved so far. And I'm going to come back and talk to you a little bit in a moment, but Leki, I want to bring you in. I was watching yesterday on the CocoNet. I just want to do a shout-out to the work the CocoNet does. It's so lovely. Ooh. But I was watching you up in UA, and the response from the audience is there. And so there's nothing like seeing yourself, right?
Yeah.
And Feely and I have spoken about this before. Historically, there have been restricted and small narratives around Pacifica New Zealanders. But all of a sudden, here you are. And what's it like to be seen and to feel people seeing you?
It's fun. It gets overwhelming at times. There's a lot of pressure that you wear. When you have to like represent people on stage, and some people don't want to talk about stuff, and then you have to bring it out in art. So that's why I really love performing arts. I think it's a great platform
because it gives you the potential to say things.
Yeah, and get away with it.
Yeah, yep. And it can. Indira and I were talking about this before. The cultural norms that the Pacifica communities have that Palangi often don't have. For example, the cultural norms around humility in the face of your elders, right?
Yeah.
But if you're able to make things funny.
Yeah.
Then you can kind of say things that you might otherwise not get away with.
Yeah, it makes it more digestible for the audience when you can make them laugh.
Yeah.
At stuff and laugh at themselves because we love to laugh at ourselves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not just about laughter though. And Feely, we're going to bring you in here. Well, I'm just going to ask Leki one more question. But there are tough truths you're confronting, aren't there?
Mm-hmm.
And how do you get that balance right?
I think you just be honest and authentic with what you're trying to say. And a lot of the work that I do comes from a place of hurt. So it comes from feeling oppressed in a system that doesn't support me. And so a lot of that work is around the revitalization and the maintenance of our Indigenous languages and using performing arts to kind of make it accessible to young people and to older people as well.
I just want to dwell on that phrase, Feely, let's bring you in here. A lot of the work that Leki's doing comes from, and I'm quoting Leki here, a place of hurt.
Mm.
And that's a place you've confronted, right?
Mm.
And so it's about acknowledging the hurt, addressing the causes of the hurt, and then overcoming the hurt.
Yeah, definitely, and providing safe spaces and the proper tools for our youth to be able to heal and to be celebrated and to know that they deserve to be loved and they're worth all the things that systemically and historically they've been robbed of over time.
The places of hurt.
Yeah, the places of hurt. And so that's why I feel like with these certain awards, it's such a beautiful platform to be able to celebrate us and all our diversity, whether it's our profession, our islands, and the way that we're all playing our part and paying it forward. So,
I'm so proud of the three of you. But I want to acknowledge that I didn't come from a place of hurt. So you carry a weight that, you know, I didn't carry at your age and that my children don't carry. Does that, can I use a really crass phrase here, but does that piss you off fairly?
I think when I think about the ripple effects and the repercussions that has on all our youth, and the potential effect that will have on our next generations and our descendants and, you know, like our future kids, I guess it really does. But transforming those negative emotions into action and into hope and into faith.
Yes.
That's the bigger, more important part of it.
So transforming those negative emotions into, what did you say, action, hope and faith.
Yeah. That's how I see it. That's how we see it.
And that's how Leki sees it.
Yeah.
We talked about this in the taxi on the way here.
Did you? Yeah. And so action, hope and faith, Leki. Is that how you see it too?
Yes, absolutely. I think you want to leave like an impression of hope on our young people because we're living in such dark times. So hope keeps us going.
And Brittany, I understand you're nodding. And so this is about your capacity as a doctor to make. Is it action, hope, and faith that led you to medicine?
Not quite, but it's something that drives me, and seeing Fili and Leki and seeing all the young people and what they do really, really drives me now. And yeah.
What do you hope to do as a doctor? What do you want to specialise in?
So I've already started specialising in psychiatry. So mental health is, where I'm at the moment, and that's my space.
And I want to go back to that beautiful phrase that Leki used about coming the place of hurt. Is that why mental health interested you?
Not initially. It was just something that I really loved. Engaging in conversations, vulnerable, open conversations with people is something I really enjoy. And now that I've about a year into my training and I see the hurt in a lot of Pacific people, I see the hurt in a lot of the Māori population, and it's not just from their lifetime, it's from the generations before them too, and all of that is impacting on them now. And I think you mentioned before, maybe you don't come from that place of hurt, but you have the ability to do things about it now in your space, and I think that's what's really important, is we can do things now.
And see it. So you know, we're just getting to grips with the fact that Oranga Tamariki lives uplifts pepe Māori babies at five times the rate of non-Māori. Right, yeah. That is a place of profound hurt, isn't it?
Oh, significantly. Yeah, I mean, you know, just if you actually think about it, and you think about that for your baby, it just, like, makes your heart hurt. How can it not? Blows my mind.
So the three of you are calling time on that stuff, aren't you? Fairly. You're calling time on that stuff. But it's not just enough to call time on it, although that's a great start. And when you call time, hopefully the rest of us listen. What you want to do is lead the change, Fairly, right? Am I putting words in your mouth?
I think it's very important to acknowledge that even though all of us are very grateful to receive awards and to be recognised, we're also very aware of the fact that it's not just us out here doing this work. It's generations of giants whose shoulders we stand on. And even the youth younger than me, I think all of us can say we're very inspired by them and very motivated to do the work that we do, especially when it comes to things like putting into action. It's exactly like you said, it's not enough to just call it out. You must act and do more. And it must be a ripple effect, and it must continue on to all the people around you. So, yeah.
I'm proud to share the country with you three. You know what I'm like, I'm a corny old man, but Leki, you need to make me laugh to save me from spitting everywhere and embarrassing.
She's joking.
But what beautiful young people, Leki. And the sense of possibility that radiates out of you makes me very hopeful for our future. It's got to be better, doesn't it? We've got to do better, Leki, don't
Definitely.
We?
Definitely, yeah. There's a quote from Epili Ho'ofa that we talk about a lot, and it's, we must establish our own standards of excellence, those that match our ancestors, and that's something that's been a driving force behind a lot of the work that we do in our community. Remembering that this is not even about us, it's about the wider picture.
Oh, I wish we had more time, although I just... I start drinking. Aigagalefili Fepulea'i-Tapua'i, who is the Supreme Award winner. Congratulations, and thank you for everything you've done on Breakfast this year. You've been a star of this program, way better than any of the presenters. Leki Jackson-Bourke, congratulations, male youth winner. And Dr. Brittany Stanley-Wishart, we so wish you well. Thank you for joining us from Wellington, and congratulations, and you're going to be a wonderful psychiatrist.
Thank you.
Thank you for all you've done and all you will do. It's been lovely having you on, the three of you.
And I just want to stand with our brother Tolefoa and say how proud we are of you two, both of you, and you too, Brittany, beaming in from Wellington. You are so eloquent, you articulate the struggle so well. In our generation, we couldn't always articulate it quite like you do. And you take our community with you. So we're so proud of you. Keep going. You give us hope for the future.